Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Bastion Slot, and I am super excited to bring you some Dinosaur Fossil Hunter tonight. This is an upcoming paleontology-based sort of game. They've just launched their Kickstarter. I'm going to link that in the description down below. Do go fund that if you like the look of the game. Check out the Kickstarter page. You get a really cool preview of what's to come and some really cool stretch goals like deep-sea diving in order to get dino fossils and stuff like that. It looks awesome. Or underwater dino fossil hunting. Looks really, really cool, so check that out. I'll link that in the description down below. Big thanks to the devs for sending me an alpha key. This is a game I already previewed a little bit earlier on, but now I get to play an alpha build. Very excited. So let's check it out. Let's click new game. Okay, start. Dinosaur Fossil Hunter is not finished yet. It's in active development and can contain bugs and performance issues. There are also missing features. If you want to share your opinion with us, please visit our Discord channel. As I say, this is a alpha, not even a beta. This is the alpha. Pyramid Games presents Dinosaur Fossil Hunter. Okay, well, here we are. This is our museum, I guess. So what have we got here? We have our little one of my mids. We have our little fern plant, our ankylosaurid of some description. I don't know what they are, just looking at them. And we have a big old sauropod and our little carnivore theropods. Very cool. Yeah, this is nice. So these are the kind of things you'll be able to make. You'll be able to put down plants, be able to put down stones, stuff like that, and kind of build your own museum displays based on the fossils you dig up. There's also plans to let you paint sort of diorama of the dinosaurs and to put up posters and decorations and all this kind of jazz. It's like the stretch goals are going to make the museum look amazing if they're matched. But yeah, pretty cool. So let's hop into this terrifying blue circle. And museum is starting to run out of free space and you think you've started, huh? Okay. Oh, wow. See what I mean? When I was 4 years old, I loved to draw dinosaurs. Oh no, that's a connect the dots kind of thing, isn't it? I thought that was the bones. Okay. Oh, okay. Why did I not expect this? Amazing. I love it. Right, I'm going to draw a dinosaur. Eh. I drew dinosaurs all the time as a kid. Hell, I still do. What am I on about? Oh no. Wait. I can fix that. There we go. That's fine. Oh no, I've messed up. Oh no. Oh no, it's gone terribly wrong. Easy does it. Easy does it. Alright, we're doing better. I can't see what I'm doing, the pencil's blocking me. But it's okay, we've made it. I'm gonna curve back down here. It's a little bit skinny on the tail, but that's okay. I didn't expect this. This is cute. Oh my god, this is a disaster. It can be two things. It can be cute and a disaster. Like an alcoholic Furby or something. Nearly there. Like 4 year olds can do this better than I'm doing it right now. Yes, nearly. Glory. Nice. All right. Now we can give it a hat. It looks like a penis. I'm gonna sign it. There you go. Wait, I shouldn't do my real signature. Let's just call that out. It was one of the most exciting days in my life. When I was 8, I found my first fossil. Oh cool, we get to do that as well. So this is like this little introduction to the story. There is a proper story and stuff like that. Let's have a little look around. It's quite a nice looking game. It is built in Unity. So it should run really well on most PCs. We might have to reduce the settings. This is on maximum, but very smooth, solid. It seems to be locked to 30 FPS unless I'm crazy. Oh, ooh. I don't know why, me as an 8-year-old child, I've been left alone in the middle of nowhere, but pick up. There we go. Left click again. Oh no, we lost it. Oh, that's sad. At the age of 44, nearly all I could think about was putting together and painting dinosaur models. I was getting better at it. I guarantee. Oh, cool. This one comes with a manual. It's dead simple. Okay. Yeah. This is super cute. Let's stick together this little bracky. I hope I get to paint it. That'd be cool. What's that? That's a foot. Is that a foot? That's a foot. It's a little tail bit over there. Oh, I've messed up. Nope, you don't. You go there. Come on. Okay. I'm just going to put you down. Is that okay? Uh, There's the head. And you're going to work this time, aren't you, buddy? Yes, there we go. What are we doing now? Stego? This one's tougher. There's no manual, but I got the sketch. Okay, so the game's not going to tell me anymore where the pieces go. I will figure it out using my large brain by clicking all over. I think that's a leg, right? I don't know. It doesn't want me. I'll put it down for now. Seems to be this, like, a little bit of an order to do this in. There's the head with his little walnut brain. The legs are weird. Let's do the body first. Get the tail in there. Some of the plates. Must be this one. Yep. It seems to want to do the right side legs first for some reason. And then the other should work. Yeah. There we go. Lovely stuff. Give me a little stego. All right, what's this? No manuals, no sketches, just sheer knowledge and skill. Oh my god. Right, okay. Yep, right, there's the head. Let's see what pieces we got here. What's that? That's an arm, isn't it? Isn't it? Apparently it goes here. It's not an arm, it's a tail. It's a foot. That's a foot. It's not a foot, it's a leg. Leg is the word I was looking for. Leg is a very confusing and obscure word, so. That's the left arm, that's the right arm. That's part of the tail, probably that bit, yep. Let's get the body together. Probably goes in there, yep. And a little bit more tail, no, this probably goes around. Put that down for now. That goes on there, that's the tail over there. There's the other foot. For that side, and let's bring that leg together. Lovely stuff. God knows what this is for. I don't see anything. Oh, it's on the it's the thigh on the other side. There we go. Maybe I could use some practice and build one of them again. Why do I need to? I'm very talented. Look at them, they're beautiful. I used to do stuff like this all the time. Oh. Even won the local talent show once. They loved my triceratops. It is the best dinosaur, to be fair. A couple of years later, the money I got as a reward in that competition turned out to be of an invaluable help. Adventures of a lifetime in your 20s? Well, I think it's possible. I was exactly 20 years old when I found an article about a paleontological group in a newspaper. Turned out they needed volunteers who were willing to work at the north of the country. It was a long shot, but I didn't want to miss such a great opportunity. I took a risk and signed up for the job. As you probably imagine, it paid off! Exclamation point. Here we are, on our job. This is the first hint. To dismiss, wait until it turns into an X, then press key. Okay, I pressed the key. You've got a message. Press M to check it out on your tablet. I've got to say, for an alpha, this is way more developed than I was expecting. I look at a lot of like alpha and pre-alpha dinosaur games. I get sent them constantly. And the only reason I don't showcase them on the channel is because they're usually like very half-baked. This is pretty cool. Welcome to the mining area. A few weeks ago, the miners came across something what appears to be dinosaur remains. We've managed to get the mine closed until the matter is dealt with. Given the fact that neither the workers nor the board of directors is happy about the lockdown, we have to act fast. Stupid people. Dinosaurs are much more important than your money, buddy boy. The crew, which was initially assigned to the case, reports that the remains are perhaps the bones of Ornithomimus. They had to leave, but according to their reports, the area is still rich in precious fossils. Your job is relatively easy. Head to the area marked on your map and leave no stone unturned. The area is marked on your radar as well, so you shouldn't have problems finding it. The off-road car parked nearby is fueled and ready. We hope your work will be fruitful. With your help, we should be able to finally complete the full skeleton for our new museum. The missing bones we're looking for are hip, right arm and vertebra. For more details, check out the knowledge tab. Okay, so we've excavated these, cleaned them, prepared them, and then put them together. And that's what you have to do for all the different bones. How cool is that? So we're going to do that for the others as well. This is really exciting. Right, okay. How do I put you away completely? I have no idea. Have a little look around. What have we got? Yeah, well, whatever. Let's hop in the car then, I guess. Somehow. Where am I going? What am I doing? I think that's what I was meant to do. Yeah, cool. Alright. How do I get in the car? Aha! Just had to escape. Okay, cool. E. M should open and close. If you're watching devs, M should open and close the tablet, I'm just saying. Follow the pointer on the compass. Okay, we have handbrake, we have forward, left. Okay, we have diff lock and 2x2 and 4x4 mode, which is oddly elaborate. Oh, not going this way. Reverse. Swing to the left. There we go. The car is making noise, it's just super quiet. Come on. Come on. Right, okay, diff lock. No, but you know what we need? We need 4x4 mode. Yeah, there we go. Very nice. We're going to stick with that. It's a rough terrain. I think we should be using it. Let's go on a little journey. The car is so quiet. It's a ninja car. So I can sneak up on the fossils. Or maybe the dinosaurs. Oh, if there's a twist. Just turns out there's real dinosaurs out there and it turns into a horror game. One day somebody will do that. Actually, somebody did. Jurassic Park S did do that. Oh. Come on, buddy. There we go. I've died already. You know, it was like a normal game and then it turned into a horror. I live for that. What is going on? Why am I so bad at this? This is why I don't drive. Oh, no. Get out of the car and use your chainsaw. Yes. All about this. Very cool. Okay. How do I access my chainsaw? 2. Alright, there we go. Just gonna cut this thing into shreds. Why not? Can I do it again? Nice! Seems I can do it anywhere. That's pretty cool, actually. There we go. Just wanna loosen the whole thing up as much as possible. I'm very angry in life, apparently. I'm just going to take it out on the tree. Alright. This is really cool. Get all that malarkey out there. Oi, you cheeky little blighter. That's probably enough room, isn't it? Yeah, be fine. Oh no. I'll be fine. There we go. Not a problem. All part of the plan, right, off we pop. The car is, it's very lightweight, shall we say. But it is fun. It reminds me of like the Mako in Mass Effect or something. All I need is some Geth to blow up and we'll be cool. We're getting there. I remember there was like a spiral, oh no. Press B to lock the differential and turn, oh, I already did both of those things, that's what happens. Is anyone else just surprised by how in depth this is? Oh no, rock. Use a pickaxe to remove the stone. Okay, so that is 3. Hey, buddy. Be for bloody ages. Alright, I think there we go. Get out of here, son. Get out of here. The pickaxe animation could do with a little love. It feels a little uneventful. I'm going to try to provide feedback as we go. It's important, I think. Not that many people have played the game outside of the company at this point, I assume, so. Right, we are nearly there, though. We are nearly there. Easy does it, easy does it. Nearly. I'm very excited about this. I'm wondering how far in the process we're going to be able to go. Are we going to be able to dig up the fossils entirely and clean them up and bring them into our museum? I'm hoping so. Get rid of those. There we go. Again. Park your car in the designated spot and set up the tent. Okay, we can do that. Oh, careful, careful. Ooh. There we go, secured. Hold space. What am I doing? Just loading this tiny bar for no apparent reason. Okay. What's going on? Ah, there we go. Right, cool. We set up our. Oh, there we go. So all I'd say is that needs to happen more gradually as you hold the spacebar button instead of just popping up like that. But that's pretty cool. We've set up our tent and everything. Let's check our messages. So we've got information that the perimeter is already secured and you can start the search right away. You're well befed. How do they know? They've got spies watching me. Your equipment is GPR that you can scan the ground with a shovel and plaster to secure your findings. Start your work with initial GPR scan. If you find anything, dig it out and secure it with plaster. You'll see further instructions on fossil transportation in future messages. So, where is our ground penetrating radar? Is it six? Is it four? I think it's four. Is it this? Yeah! Oh my god. I love this. Am I just. Is this what I'm meant to be doing? Do I use this somehow? I think I'm actually just walking around and hoping that we pick something up underneath the dirt. Which is inherently very exciting to me. Oh. I didn't mean to do that. Oopsie daisy. I finally found something. It took bloody ages to find this thing. Absolutely ages. But we found something. So I'm going to put a flag right there. Bam. Yeah, cool. Okay. So now what we want to do, I guess, is shovel. Hello. Wait, no, this is a rock. Okay, let's keep going. Down, down. Can I get rid of some of these rocks? That doesn't look like it. Okay, that's fine. Okay, just keep digging. Hope for the best. Oh, ooh, I see something. Maybe. I've dug a massive pit, which is nice. But as much as I love a big old pit, I'm curious as to what I'm meant to be doing here. This one is picking up a massive signal. This one right here. What am I looking for? I'm not seeing anything that resembles a fossil. Maybe the scanner just picks up these rocks quite strongly. Whatever reason. You see what I mean? It is that one. It's not picking up the others, it's just picking up those. I'm gonna check them all. What's that there? Why is that there? What fossil? I did something, apparently. Was it on that rock that I just picked up? Maybe. No. Did I uncover something without meaning to? Right, let's get rid of these rocks. I can't see a bloody thing. Oh, hey, what's that? Ah, there we go. You found a fossil. Bloody no, it's hard work. Secure the finding in your plaster and check out that knowledge tab in your tablet. Okay, so six. There we go. It's my big. Just don't get in there. Not a problem. It's a knowledge. What did we get? Yes, we just got the hip bones for Ornithomimus. Very cool. Very cool. Okay. So I guess that's the goal, right? Is to dig up these rocks. And these are the ones that could have. There we go. Yeah. These are the ones that can contain fossils. I'm stuck. What have we got here? You just see it poking out there a little bit towards the top, just where my mouse is right now, in the center. You see it there. That's very subtle. Okay, so six. There we go. So what was that just then? What did we just get? We just got the head and neck bones. So I was just looking for the right hand bone. Back into the pit. Is that there? No, I don't think so. Okay, I don't think this is one of them. I'm gonna have like a bad pile. That's my bad pile. Yes, that's very clearly it. Okay, cool. Let's get out of this pit. Come on. We fell in the pit. We all fell in the pit. I can't get out. I'm trapped in the pit. I'm Andy Dwyer. This is my life now. I'm actually trapped. How did I get... Right, if I just jump onto the rock, make like a little bridge. Yes, glory! Right, there's my other ones. So one more time, 6. Dunk it in. Drop it down. There we go. Oh, I have to keep doing it. That's why nothing's progress. I have to case the whole thing in. So it's not just a one dunk and done kind of situation. So let's do this to all of these. Get it nice and plastery. It did look a little weird. It didn't look like it was going to be holding it or protecting it because it was kind of like poking out all over the place. This makes more sense. Here we go. Like I'm doing a little paper mache project. Sweet. Okay, we have a new message. Fossil transportation. Once you're done with extracting and securing the findings, use your car to transport them to the transport hub marked on the map. After you do this, use your tablet to send them away to your museum. Take the rock to the tent and put it in the transport crate. Okay, cool. We can do that. So we'll just pick up these bad boys, drag them along to here. And we have a transport crate. Oh. There it goes. The lobbers. Nothing but net, baby. Nothing but net. I'm going to grab all the others first. Kind of like double fist this. That's how I do everything else. Go, and yeah, there's one more there, and then we're going to go open the trunk of the car and move the crates into there, and then we can transport them back to the lab. Which is awesome. That is such mundane stuff that I'm doing in some ways, right? You know, where put the rocks in the crates, open the trunk of the car, put the crates in the car. But that kind of like dedication to the mundane and the realism is what makes it quite... It just feels cool. It feels immersive, and like I'm actually a paleontologist, which I really like. There you go, open the trunk. Grab the crates, and in they go. Can I only bring back one at a time? They're quite huge, aren't they? Use R and B to mark the container transport spot on the map. There, right? Yeah, right, cool. We can bring them all, hopefully. Yeah. I was going to say, as much as I'm into the realism, I don't want to make that trip like 6-3 times. I don't know why it would be 6 or 7 times like I was originally going to say, but... Ah, on the roof. Cool. Close that up. Okay. Right. I guess we can head out then. The actual final game, one of the first things on the Kickstarter is for dynamic weather, which would be really cool. I really don't want to flip the car anymore. Like, I have to look after these babies. There is actually a day-night cycle as well, which I'm assuming just isn't in, just because obviously we are at a, you know, it's an alpha, essentially. Sweet. But yeah, dynamic weather and stuff like that, and it would actually make fossils harder to find in certain weather conditions, which I think sounds awesome. You know, if it's pouring down with rain, and maybe you have to like cover it up with a tarp and stuff to protect the fossils, or some rich dude turns up in a helicopter, and you have to cover it up with a tarp to protect it from the rich dude in a helicopter, and then he takes you to an island, and several people die, and it becomes a blockbuster film. Okay, let's be careful here. Let's not screw this up. I'm just gonna stick in a 4x4. I don't really see the point in not. Easy does it. Oh, little dig site there as well. Easy does it. Come on, you can do it. You can do it, car. Swap the diff lock. Come on, buddy. Come on. I feel like this is not an official road. Come on. My car needs a name. Rudiger. He's rugged. For every person, I don't. It'd be nice to have a human instead of the ghost car. Although, I like the idea a little bit that the ghost car is interested in paleontology. And you basically control the ghost car for the entire game, and it's capable of telekinesis, which is how the tools move around and stuff like that. So, I like that idea. Alright, I think we've made it. Unload the trunk and put the crates onto the skids, okay? Swap out the car. Grab the crates. Open up the trunk. Can even pick up the gas canister. I wonder why. Maybe we have to refill it for longer journeys or something, or bring a spare. There we go. Open tablet to leave this area and transport the findings to your museum or continue the excavation. Well, we're done. So, to the museum, I guess. Let's go. Yes. Okay, so I can send the crates off and then I can stay here and excavate more and then send off more crates and stuff like that, yeah. I guess. Hard to reset car position. See, look, weather. Ah. I mean, there may be levels with set weather patterns and then they want to bring in dynamic weather, I don't really know, but there's some really cool stuff in the stretch goals. I'm actually going to support the game just because I really want them to hit some of the longer ones. Like, the underwater diving for fossils sounds so cool. And there's a lot of stuff about making the museum look a lot fancier as well. Right, back home. Remove the plaster and extract the bones. Yeah, we're going to finish off our Ornithomimus. Awesome. Okay. So, I've got it. Do I put it on the table? Press E to enter station. Oh. Oh. Do I put this in the station? Yes. Okay, let's give this a go. Oh. Okay. Cut the plaster off. Very careful, I'm just trying to get the rock out. So the plaster is really just to preserve the rock for transport, right? There we go. Okay. Easy does it. Hold space to place bones onto the table. Use the tools on the table to clean the bones. Okay. How are we doing? We good? Clean? Yep. Nice and clean. There we go. God, these little bits take bloody ages. You just do it until none of the dust pops up anymore. It's definitely a slow-paced game, to say the least. You know, it's a game that's not afraid to take its time. Look at what I'm doing right now. Yeah, it's definitely happy to chill a little bit, but oh, cool looking. Oh, I have to do both. Oh my god, it's even longer than I thought. I was thinking, oh, that's gonna take ages, and I'm doing one side. I have to do both. I have to do these 3 times. Okay, there we go. Oh, we're doing something else. Spraying them down. Okay. At least I don't have to do both sides for this one. Well, I could do. Okay, next up we have a little drill bit looking thing. I guess we're trying to... Are we getting rid of the dirt? Looks like it. Okay, this is a elongated process to say the least. Okay, one more step done. That's 3 done so far. Not sure how many there are, but this one's about to finish up. There we go. Yep, there's another one. Okay. Oh, they're looking nice though, aren't they? Looking way better. This one's quicker at least. I'll give it that much. This is speedy. I appreciate that this one is so much faster because the other ones are quite slow. I'm curious how many processes there are. This looks like the last one. That looks relatively museum ready to me, but I don't know. I've never prepped bones for a museum. Prepped bones for other things, but not for a museum. Last one. Oh, no, we're back again. Okay, is that like one last clean? Yep, shine them up. There we go. This is step 5. nearly there. Nearly there. They're looking fierce to me. They're looking ready to go. Hey, right, okay, so we do have to... Yeah, now we have to put the whole thing together. Which is pretty awesome. This I'm on board with. This is very cool. See what I mean? Each individual little finger bone and everything. That is very cool. Very, very cool. How do I look down? I have no idea. That, yeah, I like that a lot. I'm a sucker for this kind of thing. They've made it a little bit difficult to get some of the Bones down here at the bottom. It's probably a way to... I can't zoom out or in. Ah, that's how we do it. Okay, cool. Tab. This should probably be the default view. There we go. A couple more finger bones, they're done. Get those claws in there. A little baby. Oh, no. Oh, no little baby. A little baby to finish things off. Hooray! Using these bones, you can finally build a skeleton. So, let's grab it. Let's nip over here. Put that in there. Done! With one of them. Okay, so... I'm going to finish this off because I've committed now and I'm doing a video and I feel like I have to. But the idea of doing this three times is making me sad. I'm not going to lie. I'm all for taking your time and gradual, but this is humongous amounts of tedium right here. Absolutely humongous unnecessary amounts of tedium. It's too much. It's too much. It's way too much. I'm so not excited to do this. And that's not a good sign. So devs, if you're watching... Don't know. I think it might be worth having a little look at this. And that's just my opinion, admittedly. Like, I could be wrong. Maybe people want to do this several hundred times. And it's not like... I mean, maybe I picked the worst one. Maybe I picked the one with the most bone or something. But it's a lot of steps, you know? It's a lot to do. I wonder if we can put the other one down now. Why are you over there? What if we can put all the bones on at once? And, like, mass do it? That'd be cool. I suspect I'm not going to be that lucky. I don't know how you'd speed it up whilst keeping the same vibe going. But there has to be a way to do it. It has to be quicker than this, because this is slow. I'm going to time how long it takes, right? I'm 47 and a half minutes into this video. Obviously, I'm going to cut it down a lot for YouTube. I'm going to see how long it takes to finish off the bones from this point forward. Let's go. I'll just show you a little look at this one, because it is pretty cool, all these, the vertebrae and the skull up there at the top. Unfortunately, these are even more annoying to clean, because I've got all these little spindly bits and little nooks and crannies you got to get the brush into. Which I'll admit, you know, is realistic, right? You're going to have these awkward bones to clean up in real life. There we go. Anyways, back to skipping forward. Okay, we've nearly finished, and my recording time, and bearing in mind, I have done nothing else. I've been sitting here doing nothing but... cleaning fossils. It is now 1 hour 6 minutes, so 12, nearly 20 minutes to finish off the last two sets. Bearing in mind I'd already done one, it's probably about half an hour in total to do this whole process, which is way too long. Way too long. That needs changing rather badly. The main problem is, there's a couple, but the main one is there's two of the tools that you use out of the five that are so much slower than all of the others. The first one, the brush, and then like the little drill bit, are way slower than all the others. All the others are kind of bearable to use, but those two are agonizing. I think just some tweaks and this would be a much more enjoyable process. As it stands, it's too slow to be fun. It just is. It's tedious as balls. I'm not trying to rag too hard on the game. This is alpha. You know, things are very liable to change. But, you know, at the end of the day, I think the feedback is important as well. And it's a really cool game, so I want it to be as good as it can be. There we go. Finished. Oh, and now there's a ghost. Sweet. It's like the ornithomimus got up and walked away. Okay. Oh, am I going to be able to do my thing? I think so. Press E to design an exhibit. Yes, very cool. Okay, we saw this in the trailer. Look at that. How cool is that? And I think I can put another one in, yeah. And it kind of sits next to it like that. That is really cool. See, this is what I mean. The game has so many awesome things in it that it just... I don't want to see it, like, lose popularity because of some... tedious bits, basically. Okay. So what have we got here? Okay, what's this? Oh. So we can kind of, like, pick the flooring, seemingly. What do we like? I'm feeling rocky today, you know? But what kind of rocky? I like that one. I'm going to go with that one. Okay. How do we get onto the next step? Ah. 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 Okay. See, this is awesome. This is really cool. I wish more games did stuff like this. I'd be thrilled if more games had things like this in. It would be amazing. I just want you to be good, game. I want you to be as good as you can be. I'm sure, like, they may already realize it. I had, like, a few ideas about how they could make it better. First of all, I do think some of the tools, these are randomized, by the way. These aren't all the same size, look. Look at that. Changes. That's really cool. I had a couple of ideas. One of them is, of course, just change the speed of the brushes. The brushes and the drill, like the little pointy pen drill, are really just way, way, way too slow. I was thinking maybe you could hire somebody to work for you, essentially, basically, and they would kind of clean things up. I'm sure there are some people out there who don't mind the tediousness of what I just did, but I think it is way excessive. So maybe you could hire someone, and it'd be optional, and they would help you in like speed along the process. They'd be cleaning some fossils while you're cleaning the others, something like that. I think if I only had to do that once, it would have been okay, but doing it 3 times was a little bit too much. Let's get some rocks in. I don't want to harp on it, but it's like the only negative I've had in the whole experience. So I just, yeah, I don't know. This is really cool. This is really cool. This is awesome. I don't even know what I'm doing. I don't like have a plan in mind, but it doesn't matter. I believe we can scale these. Yeah. Oh no. Oh. Okay. Oh god. No. Oh, no. Cancel. 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 I don't know how. Oh wait. Top left. Top left. So if we grab a rock, you can do some really cool stuff. So we have a rock. We can rotate it, and we can hold the scale. Yeah, look at that. That. See, that's amazing, right? How many games let you do that? Not many. It's a little annoying that you see here, so it's quite a dark rock, and then you place it, and then it goes like lighter. If I can show you that in a second. So yeah, the color of the rock should also reflect what color they're going to be. But I really am nitpicking, just because the game's cool. Like I nitpick because I love, you know. We're just going in hard. Ferns. I love me some ferns. I know none of this makes sense, terrain-wise, but that's I'm okay with that. It's pretty. Right, so you click the ground to do the ground, rock to do that, that to do that, that for like basal roots stuff, and can we click the dinosaurs themselves? No. Am I done? You can pose the dinosaurs, I just haven't quite figured out how. That is really cool though. That is really, really cool. You can fill your whole museum and do loads of different exhibits with the, I believe there's 9 different dinosaurs planned at the moment. I imagine they're quite hard to do. You know, there's a lot of time working these dinosaurs. I know you can. I've seen them do it. Maybe it's just not in the. It could just not be in the demo. But in the trailer for the museum building, all the dinosaurs can be put into different poses, so you can make like really dynamic scenes, which is really cool. It doesn't seem to be an option. I'm clicking on the dino. It's not giving me any choices. Move camera, move camera, so move camera, zoom in, zoom out, rotate camera, interact, place, hold the scale. Rotate object. No, I'm not seeing it. If it's here, I don't know where it is. What's this over here? Ah, right, okay, we're done. Right then, folks. Yeah, okay, so an hour and 10 minutes later, I'm finally. It's definitely very full for a alpha, you know, the game has a lot of legs and it's very, very playable. And when it comes out, it's going to be really, really cool. I have no doubt about it. They just need to fix a couple of small issues. I know, actually, the cleaning is a big issue. Biggest issue is definitely the cleaning of the fossils. I think it was maybe a little bit tedious to find them in the first place, but it kind of should be. I'd like to see maybe a larger radius on the radar. That would be helpful. That would be kind of cool if we could find those rocks just a little bit easier. I'm okay with digging them up and smashing them and looking for the fossils and that whole process. That was really cool. And the cleaning needs to be about twice as fast, I would say. I think 15 minutes is acceptable, and even that is a push. 30 minutes is definitely not acceptable. But generally speaking, yeah, I loved it. I don't want to like appear that I'm being negative because I think this is really, really cool. There's a demon outside. But yeah, I mean, look at that. That's really, even just that makes me happy. It's like a little English town. It's really cool, and it's actually probably Polish, isn't it? The game devs are Polish, so I imagine that's where this is meant to be based. It's great, it really is. Check out the Kickstarter in the description down below. Thank you again to the devs for sending me a copy of the game. I've really, really enjoyed myself with it, and it is basically what I wanted it to be, so big thumbs up. Yeah, awesome. Thank you for joining me. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and indeed this preview of Dinosaur Fossil Hunter. The game will be out at least the demo version is out in like July, so it's not like long to wait. If you do back them on Kickstarter, you get 24-hour early access to said demo. I think it's like mid-July or the 6th of July or something like that. I don't know. It's July at some point anyway. Did anyone else see that like gust of? I swear there's a ghost. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye bye.